Maybe later.
Let me know when.
All right.
How are you feeling now?
Good.
I have one question for you.
Yeah.
Why are you standing on that box?
What box?
The box you're standing on.
I'm not standing on any boxes.
You're not?
No.
Is that a soapbox?
Oh.
All right. One of the things that we have to do is project. Let's start.
All right.
Hey, who are you?
I'm Ron.
What are you doing here, Ron?
I'm here to talk about a Samsung TV today.
Samsung TV?
Yeah.
What am I doing here?
I don't know. What do you do here?
I'm here to make sure you talk about a Samsung TV, I think. I don't know.
Yeah.
I'm excited, though. This is What the Fock, where we open up boxes and we look at what the fock is in them. And I brought you because, like, you're the video guru, you know the things about the videos.
Well, let's talk about what the fuck is in this box.
I'm most excited because this is our Black Friday special. You know what I'm saying? I have a lot of thanks to be given for that.
Oh, yeah. I had plenty of turkey from yesterday and all that fun stuff.
Oh, yeah. I love some turkey. Oh, yeah. All right. So we're going to get into this box, but we're going to have to do it with a little bit of magic. But before we get into the box, we talk about the box, don't we?
Mm-hmm.
Yep. What can we talk about on this box?
Well, one thing I like about this box is there's no dings, dents, creases, pleats.
Why does that matter?
Well, it really matters because we want to receive these things as safely as possible. And the box has damage to it. That means the TV probably does too. So we want to make sure that this box is nice and clean when we get it.
And when we ship these boxes from our Dow location, they're pure, right?
Yeah, they look pretty much just like this. Because if that's not what it looks like, we would open it up, we'd check it out, and then we would sell it to you as a /O for open box.
Yeah, so everybody knows shipping and freight is really difficult right now. So every time we're talking about TVs, we do talk about the box.
Mm-hmm.
People are always surprised. It doesn't take much for a claim to be denied.
Yeah.
And we're all about making sure that the product gets there safely and in good condition. And so the most important thing is that when it arrives, you get a good inspection on it. And that if there's anything at all, right, you don't have to refuse it, but if there's any damage at all, just notate it on the bill of lading, maybe take a couple of pictures, and then
give me a heads up, please.
Yeah, and open it immediately, right?
So yeah,
you can
absolutely
take a look, because we only have a couple of days on these claims.
Receiving is super crucial. So if you don't receive properly, you're very liable to be held responsible for some damage that you shouldn't be held responsible for.
That's right. And the box is also good, right? It's kind of your everyday basic box. It's built for protecting the items inside.
Mm-hmm.
There's usually a screen guard in here, and we'll get into some of that as we open it. But you can see you've got a lot of the features down here on the side, right?
Yeah.
They communicate about some of the apps that are on here. The Bixby, Hey Google, Alexa, Apple AirPlay.
Nice little QR code so you can scan and learn more about the TV as well.
That's right. Good stuff. So how do we get into the box? Do we like mind meld it or how do we open it up?
Yeah, you mean mind meld? That could do the trick.
Should we just tear it up like a 4-year-old on Christmas?
That's what I prefer to do.
I like to do that too.
But, we got to keep this box nice and clean in case there is any damage. So maybe we should just open it the proper fashion and not tear into it.
Well, why don't you do the magic thing? You said you had the magic spell. What is your magic spell to open the box, Ron?
A little temple massage.
Little temple massage?
Yeah, just like this.
Okay, hold on. I'm going to do it.
Relaxing.
Before we do that magic, I want to do a little different magic. Now hold my hands.
Hold my
hands. Tight. Look, no hands. And I'm out of the frame. Anywho, we'll do the magic. Let's do the magic.
All right. Ready?
Oh, wait. It's still a box. Okay. What kind of magic spells are you throwing, Ron?
I said it was my technique. I didn't say it was the right one.
I like the party you do, though. Good stuff, man.
Oh, well, there you go, man.
Nice. We'll save that for later.
All right. Good deal.
So, part of your magic worked.
Yeah.
We got the 50QN90A. A.
QN50QN90AA.
Double A.
21.
AA. That's right.
Yeah.
That's right. So, kind of their elite model, right?
Absolutely.
And we do have it out of the box, right, with televisions. Kind of we left it here on the setup menu. You can see, we'll get through some of this here in a second, but you can see they do offer you two different ways to set up here, right?
Yep.
You can set up through the remote.
Mm-hmm.
We're not going to work our way through all that, but just wanted to mention
that
they
do. You can set up smart things as well. So
Smartphone, quick and easy. right?
Exactly.
And it is quick and easy. What do you have there? Speaking of quick and easy, you have the setup guide?
Setup guide?
Uh-huh.
One of my favorite features, actually.
What's that? The setup guide is your favorite feature?
Yeah, no, this remote control is one of my favorite features, actually.
I like a remote control. I don't have kids, so I need a remote control.
You know what's cool about this one, though?
Yeah, what?
Solar.
Solar?
Solar power.
Shut up.
You don't change batteries.
Shut up. Wow, do I have to take it outside and put it outside in the sun?
No.
I bring it to the beach with me?
If you want to.
How does it work?
So there's a little panel on the back of this remote control that actually charges the internal batteries in this remote. So you don't ever have to worry about finding AAAs, AAs.
Do you have to shake it like your watch?
No, it's not kinetic.
Huh.
It's just
kinetic.
Solar.
Look at you throwing those big words, Ron.
That's what I do. I drink and I know things.
Trying to make me look bad on my own show.
Oh, man. Do a good enough job of that on your own.
Solar. Whoa! Throwing shots. I like it. So take us through the setup guide. What's in there?
So first you're going to do is you're going to carefully unbox the panel, okay?
Carefully. So let's talk about that too, right? Because we did unbox it. And carefully.
Handling is very critical. You got to make sure you don't squeeze or compress the panel.
Yeah, that's the number one thing we see from RAs. If it's not damaged in delivery, it's a pinch, right?
Yeah.
Nobody likes being pinched.
I hate it.
Nobody likes it.
I hate it. No,
that's
that,
right.
That breaks my feelings.
That's right.
So, yeah, you want to be careful when pulling the TV from the box. You want to grab gently from the bezel.
Get in underneath it.
Yeah, get in
be
underneath.
Be sensitive. You want a firm yet supple touch to the television.
Exactly.
Right?
Exactly.
You don't want to pinch. We do actually see a lot of that. Guys will try to pull it from the top of the box.
You'll see a break mark right here, and you're kind of...
Immediate decline, right?
Yeah, it doesn't last very long.
Right. So you got the setup guide. It tells you how to take it out of the box. It tells you to turn it on.
Yeah, it walks you through putting it on the base.
Charge your remote. Put it out in the sun for a few minutes before you get started.
You could. But, I don't know. It's sitting on the coffee table is probably good, too.
Yeah.
So yeah, the basic startup guide is going to give you your full dimensions of the TV so you can know exactly what it was. Don't have to grab for the tape measure before pointing into that credenza.
Trying to do magic for another bottle of liquor. Sorry. So tell us a little bit about the QN50, QN90AA.
All right. So this TV has some really nice feature sets. So one that I really like is the ALR screen. You familiar with an ALR screen, Eric?
ALR screen.
Ambient light rejection.
That's the reflectiveness of the television, right? So
correct.
I can't do my hair in the reflection of the TV.
That makes it difficult.
It does.
It does, yeah.
That's actually the coolest feature, right? Because I know in my house, we've got the fan kind of right over the top of the living room, and it's spinning. Yeah, and I can see the blades spinning around in the television. It drives me nuts.
Right, exactly. So, and you're watching Sunday football, and next thing you know, the sun pops out from behind the clouds, and... Well, half your screen's gone.
Yeah, but you can charge your remote. That's the perfect time.
It supercharges the remote.
What about the backlighting on this?
The backlighting is a full array backlighting with a micro LED, or I should say mini LED. I apologize.
Not that small, but small.
There's very compact micro or mini zones in this TV for the backlighting. So what I like about it is we can actually highlight this circle in white, and the screen around it could be completely black with no kind of light bleed or blooming, if you will. So that's a really nice feature set on this TV, being a full array panel with the mini LEDs.
Mini, not micros.
Mini
exactly.
LEDs, exactly.
The other thing with that kind of ties in is their Neo Quantum processor with neural processing on it, right?
Yes.
So 16 times neural processing. Essentially, what you're getting there is an optimized picture, right?
Exactly.
It's basically going to have a little bit of memory in it. And so it kind of understands what it's doing, what type of images it's showing, and it's setting itself up for its best success.
Correct. Great video processing built into it.
And it's amazing to think, with all of that stuff built into it, that it still has some cool speaker and audio technology, right?
Yes, exactly. So it's an acoustic surface screen, everybody. And what's really neat about this acoustic surface screen is it does object tracking on the screen. So if you're watching it without some sort of enhanced audio system, an explosion happens here, the sound comes from that section of the screen. But to make it even better yet, what you can do is take a Samsung soundbar. And with their Q Symphony now, utilize the acoustic surface of the screen along with the soundbar, giving you an Atmos-like effect out of the with the screen.
Yeah, they've really come a long way, right? Samsung has probably done more from a feature set and kind of a consumer-focused production model, right? They're looking at things that the consumers are asking for regularly and really developing a lot of really great technology. I mean, they're definitely at the forefront.
Absolutely, and not to plug... per se, audio products, but what's really what people off, a lot of people forget is Samsung acquired Harman Kardon a few years back.
That's a good point.
And people know this, but a lot of people forget this. So their audio technology has come a long way since that acquisition. So I think that's really important for people to remember when selling and accessorizing a TV sale, because that's very important for boosting margins.
Absolutely. Yeah, and they really have something. I know we're here to talk about this TV, but they have something for every single customer, whether you're talking about the terrace or the frame or some of the entry models if you're on a budget. Mm-hmm. But, you know, the premium sets are really, really amazing. Tell us a little bit about the tuner that's built in, because they do some cool stuff with their tuner, right?
Yeah, they have a tuner called, it's ATSC 3.0, or commonly referred to as Next Gen Television. And what that is, that's a off-air 4K broadcast. What it'll do is it'll take some of the network components of the TV, enhancing a menu and guide system that makes it look very cable-esque. So you feel like you have a cable box on it, but you're getting terrestrial broadcast. And it's in 4K.
And it's all tied together. So you're basically looking at your programming options, and you can see off air or your cable.
And it builds even some of their streaming content into that guide, which is kind of nice. Cool. So it merges the streaming world somewhat with the terrestrial off air antenna world.
Yeah. So. And you guys might notice we still have some of the film on the TV, the protective film and some of the screen protectant. So we didn't want to take that off and get all of my oily fingerprints on it. What other features are cool with this TV?
The bezel is very cool. The very, very slim
bezel. The lack of bezel is very cool. Edge to edge, pretty much.
And
right?
It's a beautiful kind of almost a mirrored black finish. It's really a nice look. Plus, you know, another nice feature to this is everybody has a mobile device. So you have mobile to TV streaming capabilities. You have AirPlay 2 built into this. You have Miracast built into this. You have a lot of this. If you're a Samsung phone user, the experience is even more incredible. So that's a kind of a nice feature, because we live in a mobile world, and everybody has all their family videos on the phone. They have hey, check this out. I was at, you know, this concert this week. I want you to see this or whatever it might
be. Right now, we have a giant concert in the background. I can assure you, because our production staff is pretty amazing. The only question is, what concert are we at right now? Are you at is it Gwar or Eazy-E or?
I hope I'm not at Burning Man.
Right on. So what is it with this Quantum HDR 32? What's 32? What is that mean?
So it's 32 times contrast enhancement. Basically, what they're trying to do is it's their range of bright light to darkest of black. So if I'm correct on this, I want to say it's 32 times greater than the previous model.
Gotcha.
So the 85 would be 16 times.
There you go. So maybe not 32 times greater, but this is double the capability. Honestly. Don't judge us on math. We're just salespeople, all right? Give us a break here, okay? So built-in Google Assistant, built-in Alexa, right? So you can talk to the TV, have it go into different apps. You can tell it to change channels, volume, all of that kind of stuff.
You can, yes. Yeah, voice control the television through Google.
That was the easy one. Awesome.
But one of my favorite features about this TV though, Eric,
is
it actually has really strong margin, folks. This is a TV that you want
to
sell.
My man, I told you he was
here. You want to sell this TV because the margin on this is very strong. You can walk your customer into a quality TV. A lot of people forget that a TV is typically a 7 to 10 year investment.
That's right.
So you know, whether you're going to watch it in the family room today, maybe a guest bedroom later, or your master bedroom, who knows? But generally speaking, it's going to be in the house for 7 to 10 years with eyes on it. And people forget that a lot when they're selling TVs. Yeah. They think of the now, not the then.
What happened to then?
We passed then.
When?
Just now. We're at now, now.
Go back to then.
When?
Now.
Now?
Now.
I can't.
Why?
We missed it.
When?
Just now.
Yeah. It's important, right? All of our guys here at Dow are trained on these steps between televisions. And probably the most crucial thing is knowing the difference from model to model to model and being able to speak to the upgrades and why they add value.
Absolutely.
And everybody says, oh, well, this one is better, better picture, better contrast, blah, blah, blah. For me, ultra-wide viewing angle and that anti-reflective coating, I mean, pictures are amazing. All the picture is incredible now, but those two features alone are probably big enough reasons for me to do, personally, just an upgrade, because I'm tired of watching the fan and the ceiling light instead of my football game.
Well, also, a dealer can educate themselves on these topics by going to samsung.com/custom install. Register for that website. It's their 5-star premium website that's integrator friendly. It has dimensional drawings. It has drivers. It has learning resources. All kinds of information that an integrator can use to kind of sell up the TV. Why do I want to go from a from an 80 to an 85? Why do I want to go from an 85 to a 90? They can learn all those things and they can be experts on it really quick.
That's a good important fact. We don't mention it enough, but Samsung 5-star, it's amazing. You definitely want to get yourself set up and registered.
Access to improved tech support and yes, service, etc. It's really a valuable resource.
Which when you bring that up, it makes me think the other thing Samsung's really done lately is come a long way with the custom integrator.
Oh, yeah.
You know, they have really gone leaps and bounds to be the custom integrator's leading television. And to your point, margin was a big part of it. So now you can make a ton of money.
Yeah.
So besides accidentally knocking this table off of the thing, I mean the TV off of the table, what are we going to do with this TV?
Eric, I think we should give it away.
What?
I think we should give it away.
You just said it was the premium top of the line. You're going to give this away?
I think we should give it away.
For free?
Yeah. Yeah, to those who will watch, subscribe.
How can people like this?
Comment with your dealer number and name.
And tell us a joke.
If you want to, you can tell us a good joke.
Guess what concert was going on in the background? So the other thing is, as long as you're mentioning that, you can catch that. You can see these episodes on our website. And I always mention the TVs. We have a special section on our Dow website that actually lists our most profitable and in-stock television.
Yeah.
And the other thing that we do that matters for TVs is our smart services program, which gets you great shipping deals, same day courier if you're within our zone, and certainly a clean delivery of good product.
All the courier service is huge.
So we have to thank our friends at Samsung, right? Ed Ochoa and the gang. We got to say thank you. Thank you to the friends at Samsung. And we want to thank you for joining us and visiting. And I want to thank you for carrying this episode. Good job. Here, have a drink, Ron. You deserve it.